We are looking at the mathematics paper March 2017 for outside Delhi. This is section A. First question is, what is the common difference of an AP in which A21 minus A7 is equal to 84? We know that the nth term AN is given by A plus N minus 1 into D. For 21 term, A21 will be what? A plus 21 minus 1 into D. That will be equal to A plus 20D. Similarly for 7, if you place 7 here, you get A plus 6D. This is your A21 term and this will be your A7 term. The subtraction of this is equal to 84. We have to find the D. A plus 20D minus of A, this minus of A plus 6D will be equal to 84. A cancels out, you can find out the D, that will be 6. Common difference is 6. Question number 2 is, if the angle between two tangents, I'll draw the diagram for you. If the angle between two tangents, this is a tangent AP and this one more tangent, from an external point P to a circle of radius A, this is radius A, and center O is 60 degrees. So this hole is 60 degrees, we know that these two angles are equal. So we can take this as 30. Then find the length of OP. We have to find out the length of this OP. Now we are aware of this radius A. We are not aware of this. And this is 90 degrees because we know that the radius makes 90 degrees with the tangent. So we'll take the sine 30. We know that Pandit Badri Prasad, Har Bol, if you take this, sine will be perpendicular by hypotenuse. This is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. We want to find this and we have this. So we'll use sine 30. Sine 30 is A by this A by OP. We need to find out OP. So take OP here. Sine 30 is this. Sine 30 is half. So 2 goes to the numerator. This becomes 2A. OP is 2A. If a tower 30 meter high cast a shadow of 10 root 3 long on the ground, then what is the angle of elevation of the sun? The figure is like this. This is a tower AB. This is of length 30 meter. And the shadow is AC, which is 10 root 3. This is your theta. You have to find out this theta. So we have this perpendicular. We have this base. Perpendicular by base is tan theta. So we'll use tan theta is equal to 30 by 10 root 3. This cancels out and root 3 theta will be 60 degree if tan theta has to be root 3. So theta becomes 60 degree. The probability of selecting a rotten apple randomly from a heap of 900 apples is 0.18. What is the number of rotten apples in the heap? See, probability is always the number of favorable cases to the all cases, all possible cases. So here we have 900 apples. So all the possible cases are 900. And favorable cases are, we don't know, these are rotten apples. So we take it as X. But the probability is given as 0.18. So how can you get this X? You have to just multiply this. N will be equal to 900 into 0.18. That gives you 162 rotten apples. This is section B. Find the value of P for which one root of the quadratic equation is 6 times the other. So if one is alpha, you take one root as alpha, the other root will be 6 alpha. So the equation will be what? X minus alpha into X minus 6 alpha will be equal to 0. Now you solve it and you can just equate it with this equation. What we have done here is, one is alpha, the other is 6 alpha. So X minus alpha into X minus 6 alpha is equal to this. Now you can do one more thing. You know that the sum of roots alpha plus 6 alpha is equal to minus B by A. And alpha into 6 alpha will be equal to C by A. If your equation is ax square plus bx plus c, right? Same thing is done here. You have to equate this with this equation. So here you get p, this 7 alpha is equal to 17 by p and 6 alpha square is equal to 8 by p minus b by and c by. And you can equate and you can see that you get this. When you solve this, you get p equal to 3. Which term of the progression this is the first negative term? So the negative term means will be, it will be less than 0. So we have to find that an that is less than 0. So we know that a is 20, d is what? D is say 19 1 by 4 minus 20. What is 19 1 by 4? Take 19 into 4, 9 4s are 36, 3 carry hand, 4 1s are 4. This is 76. 76 plus 1, 77 by 4 minus 20. That is equal to 77 minus 80 by 4, that becomes minus 3 by 4. So our D is minus 3 by 4, A is 20. Now we'll just place it here. An. An is A plus n minus 1 into D. What we have done here is D is minus 3 by 4. A, that is 20 plus n minus 1 into D minus 3 by 4 is less than 0 because it is being said that it has to be the first negative term. Let us solve first this. This is equal to 3n, which is greater than 83. We are using this inequality. And we see n is greater than 27, 2 by 3. But it can n can only be the integral value. So we'll take 28. 28 is the first term which is negative. Prove that the tangents drawn at the endpoints of a circle or chord of a circle makes equal angle with the chord. So what we have to find here is we have to say that this, if PA is the tangent and PB is the tangent, these are two tangents drawn from P to this circle. This chord AB, these are equal angles. How to show that these two are equal angle? We know that for a triangle or in a triangle, if two sides are equal, these two sides are equal, the opposite angle has to be equal. In this case, because the tangents from any point is equal, PA equal to PB, this angle has to be equal. That is why PAB is equal to PBA. A circle touches all the four sides of a quadrilateral ABCD. You have to prove that AB plus CD is equal to BC plus D. Here you just have to understand one thing. That this is a circle which is inside this quadrilateral. So for a circle, from any point, if two tangents are being drawn, these two are always equal. So here, this DS become equal to DR, AS become equal to AP, PB becomes equal to QB, and QC becomes equal to RC. AP equal to AS, BP equal to BQ, CR is equal to CQ, and DR equal to DS. Add left hand side and right hand side. AP plus PB is what? AB. Sorry, AP plus PB, we have to just first replace. For AP, we have to replace AS. For PB, we have to replace because it is equal to, we know that this AP is nothing but equal to AS. For that, we have to equate this and PB is equal to BQ. And CQ, CR equal to CQ and DR equal to DS. So this we replace. Now we take AS and SD together. AS and SD together. Why? Because this will become AD. This will become AD. And what this will become? BC. BQ plus QC becomes BC. Left hand side AP plus BB. AP plus PB is AB. And DR plus RC is nothing but CD. That is how we prove this. A line intersects the y-axis and x-axis at the point P and Q respectively. If 2 minus 5 is the midpoint of PQ, then find the coordinates of P and Q. When a line intersects y-axis, see this is the axis. If a line intersects the y-axis, x coordinate becomes 0. If a line intersects x-axis, the y coordinate becomes 0. So what you can do here is, you can take this point. First, this point as say this point as a comma 0 because y axis is 0. For this point, you can take at 0 comma b because the x is 0 here on the y axis. On the y axis, x is 0. On the x axis, y is 0. Now, we know that if we add 0 plus a because 2 minus 5 is the midpoint. So, 0 plus a by 2 is 2. So this gives you a equal to 4 and b plus 0 by 2 is equal to minus 5. this gives you b equal to minus 10. A and b, if you place here, p and q points are this. If the distance of this from this and this are equal, then prove that this 3x equal to 2y. So you just have to use the distance formula. X minus 5 whole square plus y minus 2, y minus 1 whole square under root is equal to x minus of minus 1, x plus 1 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square. So this is the equation. When you solve it, x square, y square gets cancelled, 12x equal to 8y, and you get 3x equal to 2y, which is expected. Section C we are taking. If AD is not equal to BC, you have to prove that this equation has no real roots. To check whether the equation has no real roots or unique roots or equal roots, we take the discriminant, which is nothing but b square minus 4ac. In this equation, this is your a, this is your b, and this is your c. You just have to put b square minus 4ac, and you have to prove that this d is under root b square minus 4ac. This under root has negative value. If there is negative value inside, then the equation will not have, or it will not have any real root. So it has no real roots. So how to do this? Let us find out b square minus 4ac. So b square minus 4ac will be like this. You just solve it, you get this. And this is nothing but ad minus bc whole square. So you get minus 4 outside and ad minus bc whole square. So this is what? There is a minus sign, there is 4, so minus is minus, 4 is a constant, it will not change. But AD minus BC, this is whole square, that is, no value of whole square can be negative, it will always be positive. And it is also given that AD is not equal to BC, so this will not be 0. Okay. So this shows that this cannot be 0, this cannot be 0, so minus is there, so this is always negative. So D is less than 0, and when the discriminant is less than 0, the equation has no real roots. Next is the first term of an AP is 5, the last term is 45, and the sum of all its terms is 400. Find the number of terms and the common difference. So we have to find N and D. We know when the value and the A is given, the first term, and L is given, the last term. A plus L, this can be directly employed. So we know N by 2. A plus L is equal to Sn. Sn is given, the sum of terms is 400. A is given as the 5, and L is also given as 45. Now let us just place these values here. We can get the value of N here. N is 400. N is 400, that is the value of N is 16. This is equal to 400, I'm so sorry. N is equal to 16. Now N is equal to 16. You can find out A plus, because number of elements are 16. 16 minus 1 into D, which is equal to the last term, 45. Now we know N. We know the first term, that is 5. We just want to know the D. So you just solve this. D is equal to 8 by 3. This is the common difference. On a straight line passing through the foot of a tower, two points C and D are at a distance of 4 and 16 meters from the foot respectively. If the angles of elevation from C and D of the top of the tower are complementary, complementary means the sum of the angles should be 90 degrees, then find the height of the tower. So if we take one angle as theta, we'll take another angle as 90 minus theta. Because these are complementary, if you add them, you get 90. Theta plus 90 minus theta is 90 only. So let us see the diagram. This is the tower. A, B is a tower. H is the height of the tower, we assume, and here it is being said that the first distance 4 meter is theta degree, and because these two angles are complementary, we take one as theta, and this is the distance 16, so we take it as 90 minus theta. First of all, we will take tan theta, so tan theta will be equal to h by 4, and 90 minus theta will be equal to h by 16. But what is this 1090 minus theta? This is nothing but cot theta. Cot theta. So this is 10 theta, this is cot theta. This is first equation, second equation. Just multiply the first and second equation. This will be cancelled. H by 4 into h by 16 will be equal to 1. And you will get h. That is under root 64, and that will be 8. So this is the actual solution. Tan theta is h by 4. Tan 90 minus theta is h by 16. What you can do here is tan 90 minus theta is cot theta. You can multiply this with this, equate. H square becomes 64. H is 8 meter. This is 8 meter. A bag contains 15 white and some black balls. If the probability of drawing a black ball from the bag is thrice that of drawing a white ball, find the number of black balls in the bag. So 15 white balls, and we don't know the number of black balls. 15, let us assume it to be say n. Now, what is the probability of getting 15 white ball? That is, if there are 15 white ball, in all there are n plus 15 balls. So this is all the possible cases. And what are the favorable cases for white? This will be 15. So 15 by n plus 15 is the case for, or the probability of getting a white. How about black balls? We don't know about black. So let us, the favorable case for black is n, and the total cases are n plus 15. And here, this is for white and this is for black. But we know that the probability of black ball is given in the question is 3 times the probability of white ball. Now let us place these two and we solve for n. We get n equal to 45. In what ratio does the point this divide the line segment joining this and this? Also find the value of k. So let us assume that the line, this point divides the line in k is to 1. So this is the line, this is k is to 1. So 2 into 20, this k, 2 into k plus 3 into 1 by k plus 1 is nothing but 24 by 11. Similar is the case for y. Y is minus 2, this minus 2 into k plus 7 into 1 by k plus 1 is y. But here with the first equation we get k equal to 2 by 9, which is 2 is to 9. We can place it in the second equation, we get y is equal to minus 4 by 11. This we have got from 3, this 7 into k, which is 2 by 9, plus minus 2 into 1 by k plus 1. You have to place k equal to 2 by 9 and you get this. 3 semicircle, each of diameter 3 centimeter, a circle of diameter 4.5, this is 4.5, and a semicircle, this of radius, semicircle of this whole hole is of a radius 4.5 centimeter are drawn like this. Find the area of the shaded region. So what we will do here is, first area A will be the complete area, that is the complete semicircle. So this is the semicircle. Second area will be the area of this circle, circle with diameter 4.5, right, diameter 4.5. Then we will compute the area of these two semicircles. This will be A3, this plus this, so two semicircles. Then we have one more, which is this, A4, we can say this is a semicircle, only semicircle. So the complete area will be, or the region will be, this A1, complete A1, minus A2, this one, minus A3, these two, and plus, because this has to be added, plus A4. So what is this? This the whole one is, see, this the area of this semicircle PQR, if you say this P, and you have Q and R. So this is nothing but pi by pi r square. What is r? R is given as, this is whole is 9, this is 4.5. Pi into 4.5 into whole square. This you get as area of semicircle. This is A1. What will be A2? A2 will be this one. So this is nothing but pi into 4.5 by 2. This is the diameter, so 4.5 by 2. This is the diameter, so this will be pi 4.5 by 2 whole square. This is A2. A3 is what? Because there are 2 into half into pi r square. Pi, and this is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 whole square. These two are over. Now this is simply pi into 3 by 2 whole square. This is A4. This is what is done. Pi 9 by 4 whole square. Then this plus this, this region, b plus c, this is whole is a, this is b plus c. So pi 3 by 2 whole square, 1.5 is the radius. Then the this is the region, so we can get pi by 2, these two regions. These two regions, pi, this one. Pi by 2, this I am talking about this. Pi by 2, 3 by 2. Pi by 2, 3 by 2 whole square, because this is a semicircle. So all these regions are being computed. Now you just have to take this whole minus this and then add this. You get 99.8, 99/8. In this circle, two concentric circles with center O has radii 21 cm and 42 cm. If this angle is 60 degrees, find the area of shaded region. So what strategy we will adopt is, first of all, this area, total area we'll find. This will be nothing but pi, total area of this outer circle is pi into r, that is 42 whole square. Then we have to subtract this inside circle from this so that we can get this shaded region, pi into 21 whole square. So this will be pi into 42 whole square minus 21 whole square. Right. Now, how about this? We'll find out the sector. So, sector is what? Theta by 360, which is theta is 360 degree, into pi, then r1 square, because we want this area only. So, we have to subtract this. Pi into 42 whole square minus 21 whole square again. This is done here. This is the area of ABCD region, total region, that is this sector. Pi into 60 by 360, 60 is the angle, 42 square minus 21 square, this will be this angle, this area. Okay. Now, what you have to do here is, you just have to find out the total area, this is the only possibility. So, pi into 42 square minus 21 square, but because this region is this, we can subtract it so that we get this region, the shaded region. So, we have to subtract this region ABCD from this, we get 3465. Water in a canal 4.5 wide and 1.8 meter deep is flowing with a speed of this 25 km an hour. How much area can it irrigate in 40 minutes if 10 cm of standing water is required for irrigation? Since the width is given and depth is given, the length we will take it as 25 km. And since there are values in meter, we will change this kilometer into meter, that will be 25,000 meter. But this is in hour and this is in minute. So in 1 hour, what will be the volume? 5.4 into 1.8 into 25,000 in 1 hour, that is 60 minutes. So in 40 minutes, what will be the value? This whole multiply by 40 by 60, right? This is what we have done, 5.4 into 1.8 into 25,000. For 40 minutes, it will be 40 by 60. This is, we have used the unitary method. And this is nothing but 162,000. How about this 10 centimeter? So 10 centimeter is nothing but, we have to change it to meter. For 10 centimeter, the meter will be 0.1 meter. So the area will be what? Area is nothing but L into B into H. This will be equal to this, 162,000. Area is L into B. Height is 0.10 meter. So what will be the area? This is area. Area will be this by H. So 162,000 by 0.10, that is H, is the area to be irrigated is this meter square. The slant height of a frustum of a cone is 4 cm and the perimeter of its circular end are this and this. Find the curved surface area of the frustum. See, this is the frustum. Now, the perimeter is given. Perimeter, that is 2 pi r1 is 18. If this is r1, this is r2. 2 pi r1 is 18 and 2 pi r2 is 6. And slant height L is 4. So, we can just compute the pi r1, because we will directly use in the curved surface area formula. Pi r1 is 18 by 2, that is 9. And pi r2 is 6 by 2, that is 3. The curved surface area of frustum is nothing but pi into r1 plus r2 into l, slant height. So we can multiply pi r1, pi r2. This will be pi r1 plus pi r2 into l. What is pi r1? This is 9. What is pi r2? This is 3. So 9 plus 3 into l, that is 4. This gives you 48 centimeters. The dimension of a solid iron cuboid, this, it is melted and recasted or recast into hollow cylindrical pipe of 30 centimeter inner radius. This is in, this is radius 30 centimeters. So we have to convert it into, say, because this is in meter, we have to convert it into meter. And thickness is 5. So the dimension of cuboid is this. So volume will be, both volume will be equal. So this will be 4.5 length into breadth into height into 1.0. This is equal to the volume of cylindrical pipe. Cylindrical pipe is like this. This is 30, so radius of inner is 30 centimeter and radius of outer is 30 plus 5, 35 centimeter. We have to subtract the volume of the outer with the inner. So this is the volume of cuboid, this one. Now the inner and outer radii is 30 and 35 centimeter, which is nothing but pi by 100 square, because we have converted it into meter. It was centimeter. So pi, we are subtracting the pi r square h, that is pi 35 square h minus pi 30 square h. So this is the value, and we have converted it into meter also. Now we equate this with the length into breadth into height. So one. So h is 112 meter. This is section D. We have to solve for x. So how to solve? If this kind of situation is there, just multiply 5x plus 1 with 1, multiply x plus 1 with 3, add them and multiply these two. So the situation will be 5x plus 1 into 1 plus 3 into x plus 1 by x plus 1 into 5x plus 1. On the right hand side we have 5 by x plus 4. Multiply this by this and this by this. And this is the same situation. And you can solve this. This is 8x plus 4. X plus 4 is already there. You solve this. This will be this equation. And just take all like terms together. There will be a quadratic equation. Solve this. You get x equal to minus 11 by 17. And x equal to 1. Two taps running together can fill a tank in 3 1 by 13. 3 1 by 13 is what? 13 into 3. That is 39 plus 1. 40 by 13. This is 40 by 13 hours. If one tap takes 3 hours more than other to fill the tank. Then how much time will each tap take to fill the tank? See, the situation here is, if one tap fill the tank in x hours, the other will take 3 hours more. The other will take x plus 3. So for, just take the unary equation that x hours one tap fill. In 1 hour, it will fill how much? 1 by x. Similarly, if x plus 3, second one, x plus 3 hours, it fills 1. So for 1 hour, this is hour, it will fill 1 by x plus 3. And when you add these two, it will give you the combined time, that is 3 1 by 13 hours. And this 3 1 by 13 is 40 by 13 hours for 1. So for 1 hour, it will be 1. Just take this and the numerator, this and denominator, 13 by 40. So this 1 by x plus 1 by 3, 1 by x plus 3 will be equal to 13 by 40. So this will be the final equation. Just solve it. You'll get x equal to 5. We'll reject the negative value. So one tap, if it takes 5, the other will be 5 plus 3, that is 8 hours. The ratio of sum of first n terms of 2 AP is this. Then find the ratio of their ninth term. Here what we will do, we know that Sn, sum of n terms, is nothing but n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Sn will be n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1d, and s dash n, let us take the other one as s dash n, and we'll take the first element as a here for the first one, d as the common difference, and for the second one, we'll take the corresponding value as a dash and d dash. N by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d divided by n by 2, 2a dash plus n minus 1 into d dash will be equal to this, 7n plus 1 by 4n plus 27. This gets cancelled. Now let us divide numerator and denominator by 2. We get a plus n minus 1 by 2d, a dash plus n minus 1 by 2d dash. And this is the equation. But we want the ratio of ninth term. So this particular term has to be 8. How? We know that a plus n minus 1 into d is the nth term. So if we take 9th term, it will be 9 minus 1. So we will take n as this as 8. This will be 8 because n minus 1, that is 9 minus 1 is 8. So this term, if we equate this with this, this has to be 8, right? N minus 1 by 2 is 8. So a plus 8d, a dash plus 8d will place n as 8 here. So 7 into 8 plus 1 is 120. 4 into 8 plus 27. Is this term, and if we solve it, we get this 24 by 19. This is the solution. Prove that the length of two tangents drawn from external point to a circle are equal. If this is a circle and these are the two tangents, this is the point T. This is P and this is Q. This is P and this is Q. And this is your O. Let us join this. This is 90 degree because radius will make 90 degree with the tangent, same here. These are two radius. Let us join this also. For this triangle OPT and for this triangle OQT, OP is equal to OQ because they are radius. OT is equal to OT because this is common. And these two angles are 90 degree because they are the angle of a radius with the tangent. With RHS congruence criteria, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, PT becomes equal to QT. This we have to prove. Here, XY and X dash Y are two parallel tangents to a circle with center O and another tangent AB with the point of contact C is intersecting XY at A here and x dash y dash at b. You have to prove AOB, this hole is 90 degree. This hole is 90 degree. So how to solve this? First of all, take this OPA and AOC. Here, this angle is 90 degree because AP and AC are tangent. This angle is 90 degree. This is common. This is common. These two are radius. OC and OP are radius. So what happens here? This angle becomes equal to this angle. Okay. These two angles are equal. Now let us take these two triangles OQB and OBC. Here again, same thing. BC and BQ are tangent from B. So this BC equals QB. This is a common side, and these two are radius. OQ and OC. So this angles now becomes equal to this. Right? So if we have to find this angle, this whole angle, that is OA, OAC plus OA, or you say AOC, AOC plus this BOC. These two we have to find. But we know that AOC is what? It is equal to AOP. We just proved it. And what is this angle? This angle is equal to this angle. So BOC, for BOC we can write QOB. QOB. And these two are what angle? This we have to find. So let us see what these angles are. I hope this the solution the strategy you have known. So same thing has been done. We know that angle AOB, this is equal to this AOB is equal to AOC plus COB. AOC plus COB. But we have just proved that this is equal to half of POC, because these two are equal. And what is this angle AOC? This is half of this whole angle, that is QOC or COQ. Take half outside, POC plus COQ. What is POC plus COQ? This is whole 180 degree. This is 180 degree, so half into 180 is 90 degree. Therefore, this angle is 90. Construct a triangle ABC with side BC 7, B 45 and A 105. Then construct another triangle whose sides are 3 by 4 times the corresponding side of a triangle ABC. In a triangle, let us make a rough. A is given as, this B is given as 45, and this A, see this is B, this is A. A is given as 105, and this BC, C length is your 7. So what we can do here is, this is 105, this is 45. So 105 plus 45, what will be the angle? This will be 150. What will be this angle? 180 minus 150, that is 30. So best thing is, make a line 7 of length B and C. This is 7. Take angle 45. Make angle 30. This is your required line. Now just know the side and you can draw the 3 by 4 times. Take 7 into 3 by 4. This is your side. Again make 30 and 45. This will be our required line. An aeroplane is flying at a height of 300 meters above the ground. Flying at this height, the angles of depression from the aeroplane of two points are on both banks of a river in opposite directions are this and this. Find the width of the river. So the diagram would be something like this. This is the aeroplane flying. These are two banks of river. The height is 300 meters. The angle of depression is 60 degrees because these two lines are parallel. This angle will be 60 degrees. This is 45 degrees, so this angle will be 45 degrees. So now you can, this is quite easy because you know, you just have to take 1045, which is equal to 1, which will be equal to 300 by y. So y becomes 300, and second is 1060. 1060 is what? 300 by x. So this is y equal to 300, and x equal to 300 by 1060, and you know the 1060 value, it is already given. X becomes 100 root 3, y becomes 300. So the distance of two banks is x plus y. You have to add 300 with 100 root. This becomes 473.2. If the point this, this and this are collinear, find the value of k. These are collinear. That means the if you take these points as the end of a triangle, the area of triangle has to be equal to 0. We know that the formula of triangle is with three vertices are these. Just equate it to 0, solve for k, you get k equal to 2 or half. Two different die are thrown together. Find the probability that numbers obtained have even sum and even product. I will give you a hint and then I will encourage you to solve it by yourself. First of all, even numbers means, if these two are die, even numbers means what will come here? 1 and 5. Even. 4 and 2 even. So either 2 has to be odd or 2 has to be even. So these all combinations you have to make. Second is even product. Even product means 2 into 3. 2 comma 3. If 2 comes here, 3 comes here. 4, 2. 4 2 is 8. And then you cannot have both odd. Then you can have one more example like say 2 in 2, 2. So all these you have to make. The total possibilities, 1 is 6, 1 gives 6, 6 into 6, 36. Total possibility is 36. What are the favorable case for the first even sum? In all, if you make it, there will be 18. 18 by 36 is 1 by 2. For even product, it will be 27. 27 by 36 is 3 by 4. In this figure, ABCD is a rectangle of dimension 21 into 14. A semicircle is drawn with BC as diameter. Find the area and the perimeter of the shaded region. area is quite easy, the area of whole minus area of this portion. So for 21 into 14 is the area of whole. And what is the area of this part? Pi into 14 is the diameter, so 14 by 2 whole square, because this is half, semicircle half. So just have to subtract this, you get this shaded portion. And what will be the perimeter of the shaded portion? This is 21 plus 14 plus 21. 21 plus 14 plus 21 plus this pi r. Pi into r. R is what? So this is the perimeter. So as I just suggested, 21 into 14 minus half into pi r square. Radius will be 7 for this. This will be 217. Perimeter of the shaded region will be these three sides plus this. That is pi into r. This will be 78 centimeters. In a rain water harvesting system, the rain water from a roof of this drains into a cylindrical tank having diameter of base 2 and height 3.5. If the tank is full, find the rainfall in centimeter. Write your views on water conservation. The view is always conserve water. Water is very precious. Here, the roof is 22 by 20. Okay. So, we have to find out the rainfall. So 22 into 20 meter into the rainfall, say R or H, will be equal to the, because this is cylinder, so pi into R square, that is base is 2, so 2 by 2 whole square. This radius is, diameter is 2, so we have taken radius into 3.5. Just equate these two, you get the answer. 20 into 20, 22 into H will be equal to pi into 1 into 1 into 3.5. H gives 2.5. So this is the part D, and we have seen the A, B, C, D part of 2017 outside paper of Delhi. Thank you so much. Take care of it.